Diyos tayo'y gumawa sa ating mga kaaway. Tayo ay kanyang iniligtas. Purihin ang Panginoon, gumawit ng
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to the dead. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that always pondering spiritual things, we may carry out in both word and deed that which is pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. Adulterers, do you not know that to be a lover of the world means enmity with God? Therefore, whoever wants to be a lover of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Or do you suppose that the Scripture speaks without meaning when it says, "The Spirit that He has made to dwell in us tends toward jealousy, but He bestows a greater grace." Therefore, it says, "God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble." So submit yourselves to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you of two minds. Begin to lament, to mourn, to weep. Let your laughter be turned into mourning, and your joy into dejection. Humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will exalt you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you.
And I say, had I but wings like a dove, I would fly away and be at rest. Far away I would flee, I would lodge in the wilderness.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you.
I would wait for Him who saves me from the violent storm and the tempest. Engulf them, O Lord, divide their counsels.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you.
In the city I see violence and strife. Day and night they prowl about upon its walls.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you.
Cast your care upon the Lord, and He will support you. Never will He permit the just man to be disturbed.
Throw your cares on the Lord, and He will support you. Please stand.
May I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and His disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee. But He did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching His disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill Him, and 3 days after His death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question Him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, He began to ask them, What were you arguing about on the way? But they remained silent, for they had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then He sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, He placed it in their midst, and putting His arms around it, He said to them, "Whoever receives one child, such as these in My name, receives Me, and whoever receives Me, receives not Me, but the one who sent Me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
When we were third year theology seminarians at San Carlos Seminary, our formators formally distributed us to different committees that we will be handling for the upcoming school year. I know my prowess in terms of liturgy, in my academics, and in sports. At akala ko po, isa doon sa mga alam kong kaya kong gawin ang ihahandle ko. To my surprise, what was given to me were not what I expect, but what I least expect. To be a committee chairman for music and arts. At ano po ang kinalaman ko sa mga bagay na iyon? Nakanta ako, pero hindi ako natugtog. I can appreciate beauty, but I am no painter. Hindi po ako katulad ni Monsi. Painter yan, at magaling po yan mag-flute. No? Walang-wala po ako sa mga bagay na iyon. No? At that was my dilemma when we entered the school year. And all the while, I will be excelling with what I know. But what was given to me was the least expected I wish that I'll be handling. Pero alam niyo po, nung napagnilay-nilayan ko po ang turnaround of events na ito, siguro po pinarealize ng Panginoon sa akin, baka kung yung kaya ko na yung ibinigay sa akin, maging mayabang lang ako. Kaya naman ibinigay sa akin ang mga bagay na ito para matuto ako at para magpakumbaba ako. To say and even express that I need help, that I may be able to learn and maybe to unlearn things, I need to bow down my head and seek and be fed with the help and support of people. My dear brothers and sisters, we begin the second day of the ordinary time with hearing with the letter of St. James. And he left a beautiful remark to us. God gives grace to the humble. It is in humility that grace can flow. Kung masyadong nagyayabang, nagmamataas at nagmamagaling, baka hindi na natin binibigyang daan ang grasya ng Diyos sa atin. Ngunit minsan, ilalagay tayo ng Diyos sa pinakamababa para matuto tayong umangat at umasa sa biyaya ng Diyos. Greatness, on the one end, for the Lord, is not measured with the large volume of your voice or with the many endings at the end of our names. It is being the last and the servant of all that will definitely bring us to the greatest. Nairaos naman po sa awa ng Diyos yung dalawang chairmanship na iyon. At alam ko po, hindi naman po dahil sa galing ko, dahil sa grasya ng Diyos, sa mga utak at kamay na umalalay sa akin nung panahong sinabi kong kailangan ko ng tulong at nagpakumbaba akong humingi ng tulong at ng kakayahan din nila. Mga kapatid, ihanda po natin ang sarili natin na mailagay sa mga mabababang sitwasyon sa ating buhay para umasa, matuto, at manalig tayo sa Diyos. We might forget the Lord when we cling too much to ourselves. In humility, we also remember what we have responded a while ago. In humility, we throw our cares on the Lord and be assured, how will the Lord help us, raise us, and bless us?
Please stand.
Let us pray the Oratio Imperata ad petendam pluviam. Together, God,
our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustains your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings, and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
St. Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us. Please be seated. Stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross, brought peace to all creation. Therefore, he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us offer the prayer Christ himself taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of the salvation which is pledged to us by these mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.